Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Hawaii Rainbow Warriors and the Creighton Blue Jays.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Blue Jays are looking to make this one a blowout early. What are the keys for them tonight, Dick?
Hey, on a night like this, the keys are pretty simple, Brad. First of all, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Second of all, take care of the basketball. Turnovers can really kill any rhythm offensively. And lastly, be aggressive defensively and force the offense out of its rhythm.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Jumps in. Number 25 makes the finger roll. Both teams looking to get things going here. Well, that's good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post play.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Launches away. He gets the bucket to fall. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. They'll work it around the arc. The small forward handles the feed.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup on the outside. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Trying to go inside.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
The small forward receives the pass. Looking for contact. They just can't seem to miss.
They found a serious stroke with their shooting, Brad.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Steal. Defense giving some room. He shoots from the angle. Off the rim and no good. Takes it off him. Number 20 receives the ball. Gave it up. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going.
That's 8 unanswered.
Dumps it in. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Trying to feed inside. Goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
What a terrific job by the defense to beat him in the spot, Mr. Nessler.
Looking for a good shot. Number 33 handles the pass. There's a high screen. Way off target.
Up and inside.
In the paint.
Nice high post screen.
What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
It'll be interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Jumps into the defender, and he scores despite the hack. They look to get it to the inside. He takes it away. On the dribble, gives it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
And a momentary look from three-point land. He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. Gave it up with the fake. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
They work it around the perimeter. Looks at the three. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Takes the pass in the paint. Number 50 picks up the foul. First team foul. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Goes up for two. Hawaii is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
On the dribble, gives it up. For the bucket. Tickles a twine. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews. She's got a score for us, Aaron.
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it from where you are, but I can hear it clearly. The coach is stressing to his team, go inside, go inside. They've been effective in this area all night long. What an asset to have.
Aaron's right about that.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action. Dump it inside.
In the paint. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play. Oh, right there. They missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, beating the post.
They work it back to the outside. Fakes the jumper. From left of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
The frustration right there.
Tries for two. They are heating up this building with their shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
And the ball goes out of play. Oh, he's having fun with the opponent's stick.
He sure is, but he better make sure that he doesn't cross the line.
Number zero is seemingly at an emotional low right now.
Hey, well, offensively, he's probably not feeling it. Defensively, he's been a step behind. He's going to have to turn things around.
Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. He shoots from right of the circle, way off target. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important, get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Trying to draw some contact, perfectly executed. Number 50 fakes the shot. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
He quickly brings it up court.
Nice hop.
three-point land. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Step out on that screener.
Off the rim and no good.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rim. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
The Blue Jays go to the line for the first time in this game. Need to make that. Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, took a chance, and he lost, baby.
Opportunity for two for one.
There's the trap.
Trying to draw the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Gave it up. He throws it up from downtown. Way off target.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Looks at a three. Off the rim and no good. Puts it up. Way off target. At the half, the Blue Jays are ahead by five. Hawaii coughed up the ball way too many times in that first half, Dick.
They certainly did, Brad. I've said it a million times. Turnovers kill momentum. I don't see a lot of these kids taking my advice out there.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron.
High post screen.
He unloads. Rims out. Oh, yes.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Great defense. The crowd really admires this young man.
Yeah, they really know how to shoot.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it. Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
The center takes the pass. For the deuce. Off the rim and no good. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
He makes his second shot. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. On the dribble, gives it up. The power forward gets the ball with a sensational block.
Set that screen away.
Got an open look if he wants it. He shoots from the top of the key. The Blue Jays are ahead by eight. Number
blows the inside hoop off that set screen.
He steps up to the line. Gets the first. Foul shot, no good. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. They still don't score. Gave it up. Here's a nice face up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
We're going to move it around the perimeter. Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. He shoots from long range. Rims out.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps.
I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
First shot is good. Second one, good. Working it around the perimeter, looking for the foul. He puts it in with contact and all. He's got some room. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
That wide stance and the drop step.
I tell you, it's all about angles, and if you utilize that drop step, it's like a reverse pivot move.
Looking for a good shot. Moving it around the perimeter. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
That spin move not successful, Dick, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. The point guard with the ball. Creighton have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He buries it. Had a guy in the post, but elected to reverse the ball. From right in the circle. Off the rim and no good. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For the bucket.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block. Dump it inside.
Number 12 takes the pass in the paint. Knocks it down.
That deserves an encore. Let's watch it here.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He up fakes. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot. Great screen set up, but the shot won't go.
pressure's getting to him. Tries for two, and in and out. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stop before any further damage is done. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys want to lift their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play.
Hawaii are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but Denny does a great job in post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
They will line him up. First shot is no good. Second shot, no good. And they're catching nothing but iron at the free throw line, Dick.
They're going to catch more than that from their coach if they don't start putting them down, Brad.
Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
For the bucket. Doesn't go. Up fake. He makes a nice shot fake. He tries a jump hook.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
Nick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
Gave it up. The small forward takes the feed. Looks at a three. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Shoots from outside. He gets the shot to fall. Look out. That sends a message to the screener. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Working it around the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. They'll work it around the arc. Had a momentary look from three-point land. He intercepts it. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. A lot of time to go now, Dick, on a 7-point lead.
That's right, Brad. A lot of time. They don't need to start forcing shots.
Off the rim and no good. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? Foul, and that stops the clock again. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
And yet another foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And the clock stopped with a foul. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
He makes the front end of the one and one. Makes the foul shot. On the outside.
High post screen, gonna use it.
He shoots from the top of the key. The point guard gets the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Look at him taunting the crowd, Dick. Now he's having too much fun.
That's what may find him in big trouble with this crowd.
10 on the shot clock. There's a double team waiting there.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing the ball, ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
With the bomb. Rims out. Dick, you said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, and you look at it and analyze it because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Creighton played well against a good team tonight for the win.
They expected to beat a victor. They just didn't expect it to be this close.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.